If you're looking for a crash course in how to do cake projection mapping, you've come to the right place. In under 10 minutes, I'll show you the basics of using a free projection mapping application called MapMap to project video content on the front surfaces of a 5-tier cake with these recommended dimensions. You can follow along by downloading MapMap at the link in the description. I've also included a link to a page on my website where you can download my guide and particle cascade video for free. I'm going to assume you already have two things in place in order to complete this tutorial. One, you have a 5-tier cake, or something in the shape of a 5-tier cake to project onto, that's the size I've recommended. And two, you have a projector correctly connected up to your machine. I have a more in-depth tutorial on cake mapping for beginners, where I talk about both cake and projectors for cake mapping in more depth. I also give a demonstration in MapMap, using an optimized workflow. This video is different in that I'll be showing the easiest and most straightforward way to do cake mapping for free. Let's get started. Bring in the Layout 1 guide by clicking this piece of film. Mac users, bring in the PNG version. Windows users, bring in the MP4 version. I'll explain why later. Also bring in the particle cascade or whatever video content you want to put on the cake. You will see the assets sitting in your library. Make sure the layout guide is selected. You won't see anything in your input or output editor until you add a mesh by clicking this rectangle. These are our input and output editors. If your layout doesn't look like this, come up to Window and select Main Layout. The upper window is the input editor. In here, you manage everything being sent into the projector. The lower window is the output editor. In here, you dictate how your content is sent out of the projector. Frame the video in the input editor by hitting this magnifying glass, which fits the shape to the content view. You can also zoom in and out using these plus and minus magnifying glasses here, or make the content full size using this magnifying glass marked with a 1. Fit the video to the output editor too. Go to View, Output screen, and ensure that your projector is set as your output. Toggle full screen here to start outputting from your projector. If you can't see any controls around your mesh, go to View and select Display Controls. We're going to start shaping this mesh so that it fits around just one tier. You can pull these handles to move them. You can click and drag inside the mesh to move the whole thing at once. By clicking inside the mesh, you can cycle through some other transform tools. Click once to enter scale mode, which will allow you to make the mesh bigger and smaller by dragging the corners. Click again to enter rotate mode. You can also quickly access these transform modes with the shortcuts M for move, S for scale, and R for rotate. Scale the mesh, then pull the corners until it contains just the top left tier. Make more space for the input editor by dragging down the bottom of the window. Double-click the mesh in the Layers tab and rename it Left 1. Right-click on Left 1 and select Duplicate Layer. Click inside this new mesh and drag it down to the tier below. Then move the handles to extend it to fit around this tier. Call this new mesh Left 2. Do the same for all the tiers on the left side of the cake, remembering to name the meshes appropriately as you go. Duplicate left 5 and move it across to the right-hand side. And rename it Right 5. duplicate left 4 and move it across to its right-hand equivalent and rename it right 4. Replicate this process for the remaining tiers on the right. We've finished setting up our input. Now let's turn our attention to the output editor. View the output editor by coming up to Window, Output Editor Layout. Turn off the visibility of all the meshes except left one by clicking the little eyeball beside the mesh. Turn on Sticky Vertices in the Edit menu. Scale down left one by clicking inside the mesh in the Output Editor and dragging the corner. Then move the corner points and match them by eye onto the corners of the top left tier of your physical cake. Turn on each mesh as you go and one by one, move the corners of each mesh onto the corners of their corresponding tier of the physical cake. Once you move over to the right-hand side, make sure to take advantage of the snap feature to make sure you are matching up the left and right meshes exactly and creating a continuous seam down the front of the cake. Now we have finished setting up our mapping output. Mac users, you need to go to the Layers tab. Click on each of the meshes and change their source from the Layout 1 guide to the Particle Cascade. Windows users, you don't have an option to change the source. Instead, you should be in the Paints tab and change the video file location from the MP4 guide to the Particle Cascade. The reason I asked Windows users to import the MP4 version of the guide is because, in my experience, if you change the file location from an image file to a video file, MapMap crashes. But because your guide was a video and you are switching to another video, you're good to go. Don't forget to go to View and turn off Display Controls. Now we can see the Particle Cascade mapped to our cake. If you want more videos for your cake, head on over to my shop. I've got content to purchase which is perfect for weddings and all kinds of celebrations. You've just learned how to cake map in under 10 minutes. If you have questions, drop them in the comment section down below. If I've helped you, hit that like button to say thanks, and definitely click that subscribe button if you don't want to miss out on any more cake mapping and projection mapping tutorials and videos.